Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this session, we will get acquainted with the text input component and learn how to use the soft keyboard in different ways. In the previous session, we got acquainted with flat lists and section lists and displayed a nested array using them. Now I make changes to the page to prepare the environment for our work. Well, first I create a view and give it the body style. I define a text in it that guides the user on what to do. I give it the text style we created earlier. I make it a little smaller to fit the page. And in body style, I put align items in the center to make it look better. Now below this text, we want to get the user's name. Here I create the text input component and make sure it's imported from the React Native library. The text input component is here, but it's not visible because it's not styled. If I click on it, you will see the keyboard pop up. In order for the input environment to be recognizable to the user who can click on it, we need to define a style for it. I name it input and define it in a style sheet. I create a border width for it with a value of 1 so that a thin line is drawn around it. Its width is only a few letters by default. We can consider a fixed width, for example 200 for it. I make the border gray and round the corners a bit by giving border radius. So now I create a placeholder for text input to create a light text guide for the user inside. This guide is displayed in text input in light gray, and this appears when the first character is entered. To display the text inside text input in its center, we can use text align in its style and center its value. And to increase the size of the text, we use font size in style. I make it a little bigger to look better. So now we want to use the value entered in text input and display it below. To do this, we first create an empty state. Then we create a text below text input and use the state we created in it. Now in the text input component, we use unchanged text to return the value entered in it. As its value, we define a function that changes the value of the state for us. The value that this function returns is the same value that has changed in text input, so we save it in the state. Now I enter some value in text input, and you see the text below the change as I type. This button on the keyboard is the confirm button, and clicking on it will close the keyboard. Text input is one line by default and doesn't allow the user to display text in multiple lines. By adding multi-line, you can add this feature to it. Now the confirm button on the keyboard becomes the enter button, which can be clicked to create a new line. If we go to the text input document in component section of the reactnative.dev, we can find the many props that this component accepts. For example, keyboard type prop changes the type of keyboard when it comes up. Here you can see pictures of different types of keyboards for Android and iOS devices. These few types can only be used for iOS, and the last type can only be used on Android devices. For example, if we define the keyboard type numeric here, the keyboard that opens will only allow us to type numbers. And if I change it to phone pad, it will be used when we want to get a phone number from the user. The default type also exists by default, and if we delete it, there will be no change. There are no limitations on entering characters by default, and I can type as many as I want. Using max length, we can specify the number of this limitation. For example, if I set the number 2 to it, it will not allow me to enter more than 2 characters. And if I change it to 4, it will not allow me to enter more than 4 characters. There may be times when we want to disable text input so that the user can't type in it. We do this using editable prop, and if the value is false, text input is disabled and its color is different from active text input. If we want to use text input as a field where the user wants to type the password, it's better to hide the characters after entering. We do this using secure text entry. Now by entering the characters, we see that after entering, they become dots, but their value is preserved. Also, normally if you click outside the text input, nothing happens and the keyboard doesn't close, and you have to do this by pressing the back or confirm button. In one of the channel videos, I have explained the way to do this that you can see. So there we go, we learned about the text input component and how to use the soft keyboard. So in the next video, we will talk about the button and touchable components. Now, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to share, subscribe, and like, and I'll see you in the next session.